this your first time learning a new language? Have you been studying for a while, or you feel like you're not making as much progress as you would like?
We were just kids.
Hey guys, what's going on? Adan Sensei here, polyglot and passionate language learner, bringing you tips and tricks to learn languages faster and smarter. Remember to hit that like and subscribe button. Give us your opinion in the comment section. And now let's get ready for the video. All right, tip number one, have reasonable expectations. Is the language that you're trying to acquire very close or very far from something that you already know? What do I mean by this? Let's say that I'm a Spanish speaker. I'm trying to learn Portuguese or Italian. These languages are very close to something that I already know. Portuguese, when I first started learning it, I didn't even need to pick up a textbook or anything. I could immediately understand what they were saying. I could hear out many words. I could notice that certain ways of saying things were very similar to what I already knew. So this made it much, much easier. In contrast to that, when I first started learning Japanese or Korean, these are languages that were totally different to something that I was used to. One thing that I notice that I see that discourages a lot of beginners, especially I see it a lot when it happens in bilinguals. Let's say that they grew up with English and Spanish or with French and English or something, and they go with the same mentality, thinking that it's going to be just as easy to pick up Korean or Japanese or Chinese, thinking that the same habits that they use are going to help them, and then just hit the wall and get discouraged because, you know, they don't have a strategy to how to learn it because they never really had to. In this case, I see a lot of people just getting really disappointed and discouraged and then just stopping to learn the language. If it's a language that is very different from what you're already used to, just know that it's going to take a little bit more time until you start getting those results, as if you were learning something that was already similar to what you know. Tip number two, learn enough grammar to understand and comprehend what you're studying. Personally, I don't study too much grammar. Depending on the language that I'm trying to learn, I try to keep away from it. So I study enough so that I can understand what's going on. My biggest enjoyment is when I'm actually talking to people. My preferred way of studying is using sentences. Sentences with sound, preferably. I try to pick up the grammar as I go along with my sentences. If I'm reading a sentence and I'm trying to memorize it or I'm trying to get used to it, but it just doesn't make sense time after time after I've gone through it, then I'll try to see, okay, maybe it's the grammar that I'm not understanding. In those cases, then yeah, I'll pick up my grammar book and I'll check it out. For example, when I first started learning Italian or Portuguese or French, my goal was how fast can I actually start going out there and speaking? So I exposed myself to a lot of sentences. I was just trying to pick up the grammar and trying to see how it sounded. And I immediately found people to practice with, but I kept my grammar to a bare minimum. I was actually getting a lot of muscle memory practice as I was doing this. For something like Japanese or Korean, with no grammar, you're definitely going to sound pretty weird. So in that case, if the language that you're studying is very different from something that you already know, then yeah, you're going to have to increase your efforts on really understanding the grammar and what's going on, because without it, you're not going to function at all. So finding that balance of just enough so that you can go out there and use it, I think is the best way of going about it. Next tip, practice with someone consistently. If I could choose two out of all of these, this would be on that top list. Practice with someone consistently. In the end, why are you learning a language? If your goal is not to speak it, but to read it or to do something else that's not speaking with it, then ignore this. But if you really want to go out there and meet the people and communicate and express yourself and all those cool stuff, then you're going to have to practice with someone. How do I practice with someone consistently? I live in the middle of nowhere. I'm trying to learn Japanese and there's no Japanese people near me anywhere. When I was first learning Japanese, I was in Mexico. I didn't have any Japanese people around me, but I did have one thing. It's called the internet. There's a lot of great services and apps out there to go and find people and practice with them. My favorite ones, which is iTalki and it's HelloTalk. These two are probably the most known services out there that can help you go and find native speakers immediately. So they all have their pros and cons. My favorite one personally is iTalki because I can just go out there, find someone that meets my budget, and I can consistently schedule classes and practice sessions with them without too much fuss. HelloTalk is also pretty awesome, but it usually requires a little bit more time to get some really good serious practice. It's more of like a chill kind of thing, unless you know what you're doing and you know how to, you know, make relationships with people and get their confidence and go on and actually focus on doing real conversations consistently week after week after week. It's not that easy. It's possible. I've done it, but it just requires way more much effort than just going into iTalki, scheduling your teacher, and then just doing that twice a week or three times a week or once a month or whatever is comfortable for you. This, if you can consistently get yourself to practice, this is going to increase your motivation so much more because you're actually going to feel that all your study efforts and all that information that you're putting into your brain is actually being used somewhere. You're going to get feedback from the people, good or bad, but in the end, you're going to be actually growing. That's where the rubber meets the road. That's when you're going to see progress. Next tip, have a good study and review system. My favorite tool to use to study, hands down, is Anki. Why? It has one of the best SRS, spaced repetition systems, built into it. It's very highly customizable. And if I need to, I can turn a whole book into flashcards. It just makes my studying more seamless. I can take it on my phone or I can do it on my computer. It's everywhere where I need it to be. And I can study as much as I need to thanks to its built-in scheduling features. There's a lot of websites that help you make flashcards. They're all great. As long as you're using something to review the material that you're studying, then that is perfect. I see people that create their own paper flashcards and it works really well for them. That's really good too. So next tip, know the difference between active studying and passive studying. These both are equally important because they complement each other. So active studying, what is it? If you're actively studying from book, let's say you're practicing grammar, you're studying kanji, you're studying verbs, you're actively trying to absorb a piece of material, preferably you want to do that in non-interrupted and full focused periods of time. Let's say 30 minutes, let's say 1 hour, and you want to be taking breaks in between. This is super important, but at the same time, it can be very tiring. It requires more willpower. It requires more effort from your part, so it's not as easy to do. The opposite of that is passive studying. This one, it can be a little bit tricky and a little bit on the gray zone. My personal favorites for passive studying is watching movies, watching dramas, listening to music, anything that's fun with the language. I'll watch Netflix with captions in the language that I'm trying to study, and I can tell the difference between me actively focusing on trying to understand something that's kind of difficult and the level of energy that I use when I'm just chilling on the couch, watching a movie and just enjoying myself. I'm still kind of getting exposure to the language. There's no pressure. You're not really trying to put all your effort into it. You're just kind of trying to expose yourself to the language. And I think this is super, super important. For dramas that I already watch but that I really enjoy, I would just keep them playing in the background when I'm going to work or when I was doing something else that didn't require that much focus. I was actively being exposed to the language in a passive way. So I think knowing the balance between the active and the passive ways of studying, since they're both equally important and they complement each other, is really key. Next tip is use deliberate practice. For deliberate practice here, I mean any language is going to have its challenging parts. If you can identify upfront what those challenging parts are going to be, and you can map out strategy of how you're going to go and tackle it, it's going to make you much, much more effective at it. Let's say that you're studying Chinese or Japanese. A lot of people, they dread the Chinese characters here, the kanji, the hanzi. Find the best strategies out there. There's a lot of great people on the internet sharing their strategies on how to conquer them, how they conquered them. If you can find those strategies and just deal with that particular part, then you'll be much more effective. With Chinese, when I was first starting out, I could definitely see that the pronunciation was very, very different than from when I started learning Korean or Japanese. I was not used to the tones. I was sort of learning it. I tried speaking with people and they were just telling me, I don't understand you. I don't understand what you're saying. And that's when I really decided, you know what? I need to get the tones down. So I went in, I researched it, and I found apps to help me practice the tone, to recognize the tones. There's things called drill pairs where you're actively mixing different number of tones and you're practicing it and practicing and practicing deliberately so that you can actually make your pronunciation sound much, much better. For languages like Portuguese or Italian, one of the biggest challenges here is the verbs, the verb endings. If it's me, if it's you, if it's him, the verb ending changes. So finding apps that help you practice just this can really help you overcome that challenging part of the language. So use deliberate practice, find the most challenging part of the language and commit to getting that single one part down with deliberate practice. And finally, my last tip, balance input and output. In other words, balance learning and balance doing. In the end, why are we learning? We're learning because we want to go out there and do something. In this case, we're learning a language so that we can go out and do something with it. Speak with someone, maybe read something, maybe watch movies, whatever. Whatever it is that you're trying to learn, go out there and do it. I see a lot of people making the mistake of they're really afraid of going out there and trying to practice the language. They think that, oh, maybe I just need to study way more so that I won't make any mistakes. It usually happens to perfectionists. It's happened to me, not just in language, in other things. You know, you try to learn too much about it before you even attempt in doing something because you don't want to fail. But the truth is that if you actually learned a little bit and then practiced it, and then tried it and got some feedback on it, when you do your learning again, it's going to be way more effective because you're balancing that doing and that learning. So finally, question of the day. What are your favorite techniques and strategies when you're learning a language? Remember to share your opinion in the comment section. All right, guys, that was it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to like and subscribe. This was Adan Sensei. Remember to always strive to learn languages faster and smarter. I'll see you in the next video.